Hi, everybody. It's me, Jessica, your health fitness program manager from McLean, and I'm turning off the air conditioning because I'm ready to guide you through today's Tabata HIIT circuit. We're keeping up those super sets. So instead of doing 8 rounds of 20 seconds on, 10 seconds off, continuing with the format of 4 rounds, 40 seconds on, 20 seconds off. So I want you to push yourself really hard during these 4 work intervals per exercise. For almost all of the exercise, I'm gonna offer you an option to challenge your balance or just make things a little bit harder for the last 2 rounds. I'll show you what the move is in between. You can give it a try. Doing your best is all that we're asking for every single day. So if you try the harder move and it doesn't work for you, that's fine. You can always revert back to whatever it is that we've started with. If you find that you need an additional modification and you're watching us live, put a comment in the chat. Jen can always help you out. And otherwise, leaving a comment, we'd be happy to respond later. Yay! You got a couple minutes till we get started. I would recommend putting some music on to keep yourself as motivated as possible. I know when I'm personally working out, I love to have music going because then it really keeps me even moving for those active recovery times for the 20 seconds of rest, and I get so much more excited to jump back into the workout. Make sure you have water available. If you can keep your air conditioning on, I would recommend it. You might even want a towel today. In fact, I'm gonna go get a towel because things are gonna get a little sweaty. Let's take this towel. Okay, I'm gonna get a little sweaty. And I just want to make sure that nobody slips while you're doing planks. So having a towel around just to keep yourself safe sounds great. We got 2 minutes till we get started with our warm up. Yay. All right. One minute till the party starts now. Oh. Okay. Cool. Yep, gonna take some water before we even get started. Knowing that I was turning my AC up to 80, I've really been focusing on hydrating today so that I'll continue to feel good during class. Remember, if you're exercising while dehydrating, that's just going to increase your heart rate. It's gonna make you sweat more. It's gonna make you feel a little bit more tired than you already are. So one of the easiest things that you can do is just drink some water throughout the day, making it a goal to drink about half of your body's weight in water. If you don't wanna step on the scale, you don't have to. What do you think you weigh? Drink half of that. Okay, it's that time. So step away from your desk. We are gonna use some weights today. I can't even remember what the moves are off the top of my head. Oh, we're only using weights for 2 moves. So you're gonna wanna wait for your rows, and then you're gonna want a much lighter weight or maybe no weight in your hands at all as we come into like a seated scapular row. Okay, change direction of those shoulder circles. Wow, my upper body's really tired. I'm gonna separate to individual shoulder rolls because I also think that helps to release a little bit of the abs and the back a little bit more, and it just feels good. All right, take a moment, just shake it out. Hopefully you've got some music on. Shake for a second to the beat. Shake through those hips. Shake through those legs. Shake your fingers. Shake your wrists. Cool. Let's make our way to the end of the mat. We just got a couple moves in today's warm-up. So we're going to go for some up-downs. We're going to do an inchworm. We're going to get the world's greatest stretch. And then a little stretch into those legs nice and deep. All right. So for these up-downs, You're gonna reach all the way up towards the ceiling, draw your belly in, and then reach down to the floor. Go at the pace that works best for you. So if you can move fast in this one, I encourage you to move fast in this one. You can bend your knees if you need to. If you are bending your knees, make sure that you're keeping the weight in your heels, that you're not bringing the weight forward to your toes. And the more straight that your legs are, the more stretch that you're gonna get right now into those hamstrings. Just about 20 seconds left, and then we're gonna move right into some inchworms. I want you to think about taking your time on the first round, but then adding a little bit of speed here. Ready for those inchworms? 3, 2, 1. So hands down, walk yourself all the way out. Shift the weight forward, shoulders on top of hands, palms, and then walk yourself back in. Reach all the way up towards the sky. Find that really big lift. And now work to move a little bit faster. We're going for 1 minute. So see how many inchworms you can get in 1 minute. As you come forward, think about squeezing your glutes. Squeezing your glutes, drawing your belly in, and pressing forward. So that your hips come in line with or slightly below your head and shoulders. Just trying to get you out of that down dog form of keeping your hips towards the back of the mat, which is still a great stretch. Just trying to bring a little upper body action into play. 10 seconds left. 3, 2, walk yourself out into your plank one more time. From here, we're gonna bring that right leg forward. Keep your left hand down on the ground. Stretch all the way up towards the ceiling. I want you to really reach up. Find that chest opening and that back engaging as you reach up. Then hand back down. Switch. Left leg comes forward. Reach up. Find that little hinge forward. So you start to feel that stretch happening through your glute as well. If you need to bring that back knee down towards the floor for some balance, go for it. But if you can keep that back knee up, challenge yourself to make it happen. We're getting a total of 5 on each side. So if you're moving with me, this is number 3. And then we're gonna hang out in the hip opener. Oh my gosh, already it's feeling pretty warm in here. One more. And then you'll step that right leg forward one more time and plant that left knee on the floor. Ready? So step into your plank, right leg forward, left knee down. Take a moment, lift yourself up, and then shift forward. Find a little opening of those hips. Inhale your arms up overhead. Oh, actually, just inhale your left arm up overhead and find a reach over to the right side. So inhale, lift. Exhale, reach. 2 more. Inhale. Lift yourself back up. Still have that back glute squeezed and pressing forward. Finding that reach. Oh, so much love happening throughout the left side of the body. Awesome. Let's switch it up. Bringing that left leg forward. Hinge forward. Inhale your right arm up overhead. Left hand fingers just reach down towards the floor. And then lift back up. Oh. 2 more. Awesome. Go ahead and release your knees down to the floor. Take a moment. Let's stretch out through those shoulders. Send your hips back towards your heels for some child's pose. Feel that big stretch in your upper back. And use your exhale to create a little extra length through your tailbone. Imagine every inhale, you're sending your breath there, and every exhale, it's filling up the space between your vertebrae so you can create that extra length. On your next inhale, pull yourself forward. Take a moment in cobra. Then go ahead, tuck your toes under. Walk your hands to your feet or your feet to your hands. We're going to go ahead and get started. All right. Solid warm up, y'all. Hopefully you're feeling warm. It's not just me being in this hot room. The first move that we're gonna go for are in and outs. So you can take this at the pace that works right for you, stepping in and stepping out. If you can really go for it, in and out. And if you wanna challenge yourself, you can walk forwards and backwards just to get a little bit more engaged. We're gonna do that for the first two rounds. You can stick with it for the third and fourth. We're gonna add in jumping jacks, just making it a little bit more challenging to get those legs out and in. And sorry, neighbors, but I'm gonna try and join you guys in the jumping jacks today. All right, we start those in and outs in 3, 2, 1, belly in, begin. So think about using those arms too. As your feet are coming down to the floor, you're pressing down mindfully, starting to warm up those calves also by being on the balls of the feet. You can either go for runner's arms or just swing your arms side to side, out and in. Challenge yourself if you want to, a little forward and backwards. Maybe a little crabbiness side to side. It's a little harder to get that crabbiness side to side, but I just want you to have some fun. Starting to get those heart rates up, just moving. Getting away from our desk. All right, which foot did you lead with? Do you remember? Challenge yourself by leading with the opposite foot this time. Get a nice long 20 second break, but I want you to think about how long 20 seconds really is. We got 3 seconds till we start again. And begin, opposite foot starts the motion. And you can always move slower, out and in. If you're moving slower, you even have an opportunity to bring the weight into your heels, come into a little bit of a squat here if you want to, or keep the challenge a little bit more in the calves by staying on the balls of your feet. Just get some motion in that upper body. The more your arms go up overhead, the more energy you're going to be burning too. And that's why we're stepping it up if you're ready with jumping jacks next. Now you can always do the Freddy or tap it out side to side and still get that overhead arm motion. 3 seconds till we jack it out. 2, 1, begin. So you're trying to land light on those toes and you're really working to bring those arms all the way up overhead, nice and wide to the side, and then bring them down. That look on my face is me just trying to notice if I'm being too loud. Make sure you're still breathing. If you find that you're having trouble breathing, take it down a notch, either stepping it out or coming back to those out and ins. Yay, 1 minute down, 1 minute to go. If you want to challenge yourself in this last 40 seconds, not even a minute, you can always jump forward and then out. Last time through of our cardio interval. Begin, so forward and out. Just controlling through a little bit more range of motion. Are you still working to bring those arms up overhead? Not just flinging them, thinking about squeezing a little bit through that upper body to get your movement. I hear someone in the stairway, so I'm just gonna switch to in and outs. Yes. All right. Let's make our way down to the floor. Grab some water if you want to. I'm going to grab some water. It's a little spicy in here. And it's only going to get sweatier. So next up, we've got a plank round. Remember, if you have trouble with your planks, you don't have to be in that iso-prone position, like a push-up. You can always drop your knees down towards the floor. challenge yourself, see if you can come into this checkmark form instead of automatically coming into tabletop and taking it super easy on yourself. But if you need to be in tabletop, you can still get some great range of motion. We're gonna go from plank and just rotate one arm up at a time. That's it, same move coming up for the next two rounds in 3, 2, 1, begin. So challenge yourself, be on those toes as much as you can. Opening your feet out a little bit wider is gonna help you create a nice stable base. I want you to work to control bringing your hand back down towards the floor. So not slamming that hand down towards the floor. And if you need to, you can always just hang out in a plank. And if your wrists are hurting, you can do this same motion on your forearms, rolling from side to side. 3, 2, 1. Awesome. In fact, you know what? I'm gonna challenge myself to come down to my forearms for round 2 and roll it out side to side. Give my wrists a little break because we're gonna come back to those wrists for sure on round 3. 5 seconds till we get started. 3, 2, 1. As you saw, before the timer even beeped, I got myself set up into my plank position so I can get a full 40 seconds of work here. And if I need to take a break, or if you need to take a break, and then come right back into the motion as quickly as you can. Almost there. Oh, 3, 2, 1. All right, we're gonna change up the move a little for this next round. I'm gonna have to turn this way to get some space, but going from a regular plank, you're going to bring your arm up and back like you're swimming, like you're doing the breaststroke. So if you need to be on your knees, if this range of motion begin is too much for you, try it on your knees. All right, you're gonna face this side of the room. The interval has started. Now you can go with a nice straight arm all the way around, or you can actually mimic swimming and start to get that row back and then bring it up overhead. Ten seconds left. Three, two, one. Nice work. We got that same move one more time. So yeah, face this way for funsies. Oh, it's sweaty. Ready? 3, 2, 1. So in that plank, arm goes back and then around. You can keep a big circle, or just like swimming as that arm goes over your head, if you want to dive it down, you're welcome to do that as well. Maybe a little bit of both. Keep that belly pulled in tight. Keep those glutes engaged. Remember, you can drop to your knees if you really need to, but ask yourself, do you need to or do you want to? We're close, y'all. Oh, we made it. We made it. Enjoy your break. I think we stay down on the floor for our next move. Yes, we stay down on the floor, and I encourage you to get a very light weight. Thinking about a weight that's, I'm gonna use 1 pound weight. 3 pound weights might be good. Just holding onto a water bottle, literally just holding your arms up, is gonna create a big challenge. All right, so for our first move, we're gonna go for a boat pose kick out. So you can bring your arms down to the floor behind you and press through one leg and then the other. Thinking about bringing those shins right back to parallel to the floor. And you can make it harder by not placing your forearms down on the floor and finding that same press up. Oh, y'all ready for this? 3, 2, 1, begin. So either forearms or maybe your hands down on the floor behind you as you work to press or pointed toe, one leg and then the other. I like this one with the pointed toe, or lifting yourself up. If you do lift yourself up, make sure that you're not rounding through your back here by having your elbows on the floor. It's helping you to keep that chest lifted. 10 seconds left. Can you challenge yourself here for these last 10 seconds? We've only got this same move one more time today. Do you feel how hard those abs are working? Take a break to draw that knee back in. That's some good work. Oh my gosh. All right, one more time through, just like that. And then we get to plant our feet on the floor. So breathe it out right here. Make that exhale longer than your inhale. Bring your heart rate down and begin. Keep that chest open and that back nice and long. If you need to put your arms down, I do. I need to put my arms down for a sec. But with my arms down, I can focus a little bit more on really feeling those abs work. Oh, reaching a little bit further with that toe. All right, last 10 seconds. Oh my gosh, okay, we made it. All right, for our next move, you're gonna keep your feet planted on the floor. You're gonna take a little bit of a lean back, and it's a teeny little row. So I'm barely moving my chest. You can actually keep your arms bent and just find, oh my God, a little pump through. Begin, so just a teeny little pump, pump. So squeeze those shoulders blades towards each other. Find that extra little lift of the chest. Oh my God, my back is already tired. Oh, come on y'all. We got just about 10 seconds left right here. Bring those elbows a little closer in line with those shoulders instead of having them forward by your chest. Oh, take a break. Oh my gosh, wow. So this is a move that can be super challenging even without any weights. I'm making sure to keep my arms at a 90 degree angle. So I'm not bringing those hands in like chicken wings. Hands, palms are in line with those elbows. Just a little squeeze and lift. You're ready? Begin. You can press those heels into the floor. So really focus on the squeeze that's happening with that upper back. Shoulders are probably starting to get a little tired. Why are my quads so tired? More than halfway through. Less than 10 seconds. Come on, we got this together. Then we get to stand up. Oh my gosh, we made it. Shake those shoulders out. Wow. Take your time, carefully make your way to your feet. Oh my gosh. Okay. All right. For the next round, we're breaking down a squat thruster. So you're gonna go from a nice, you can go for a goddess squat if you want to. So feet can be really wide. I have my heels on the mat and my toes gently pointed out. And you can squat down really low and wide to work a little bit more of those glutes. If you wanna work a little bit more of those quads, the goddess squat also works the inner outer thighs. The regular squat's gonna work a little bit more of those quads. So you can still go for a regular squat. And then you're going to step back into a lunge, squat, step back into a lunge. That's move number one. If you don't want to step all the way back into a full lunge, you're just going to squat and step back. Squat and step back. As you step yourself forward, make sure that you're stepping forward by pressing the weight into your front heel, not by pushing or rocketing yourself off of your back leg. So if you find that you're rocketing yourself off of the back ball of the foot, I want you to shorten your step, come into a little bit more of a single leg squat, and then step forward, okay? You ready? We start in 3, 2, 1, squat to lunge. So squat, and then step back. Think about bringing that back knee down to the floor, weights in your heels, stepping up, pressing through that front heel. Once you got the move, I want you to work to bring a little bit of speed. Can you tap that back knee down towards the floor? If you can with control, great. No slamming, just a little tappa, tappa, tappa. Or you're going for this shorter single leg squat option. Take a break. So either that full lunge or a single leg squat. Something for everyone. Or just a little step back into balance. Ready? 5 seconds till we start again. Less people light and face forward. Okay, begin. So squat, lunge, squat, lunge. Make sure as you're squatting, you're really reaching for that imaginary chair behind you. So frequently, the more that you sit at a desk, the more likely it is that you might want to squat and let your heels lift up off of the floor. Limit your range of motion so your heels stay on the floor. Because you got to press back up through those beautiful heels. Oh, okay, yay. All right, next we're coming into a squat thruster. So same squat at the top of your mat, and then you're either gonna step or jump back, one or both legs at a time, into a plank, come back forward, squat, and then plank. Ready? Begin. So hands down, easier version. Oops, I forgot the squat. Step up, stand up, squat. Then come down, either step or jump into your plank, step or jump forward, stand, squat. Thrust back, come forward. If I was not worried about my neighbor at all, as soon as my toes touched down in the back, they would spring forward. But I gotta take an extra second, because I gotta be polite and make sure that I'm not slamming on the floor too much. One more round of thrusters, just like that. Get a little movement going, active recovery. Don't completely stop. 3, 2, squat thrusters if you want. Add a hop at the top. Okay, I'm gonna have to step it back. Getting a little paranoid up in here. If you're stepping it back, think about alternating the leg that you're stepping back with each time. 10 seconds left. Keep that continuous motion going. You did it. All right. I'm excited for our next move. I was a lot more optimistic this morning when I was writing class. Like, I'm going all out. But starting to rethink that judgment. Due to neighbor paranoia. So let me tell you about your two options for our next move. All right, if you can be a little bit more intense, you're going to just split jump. think if I do it on top of this mat and on top of this towel, I don't know, I'm scared. Okay, so if you're like me and you're living in the apartment and you're like, that's not gonna fly, you're just gonna get a continuous knee drive, or actually, let's tap forward and back. Let's tap forward and back, I like it. So jumpers, you get to jump forward, split jumps two times. Tappers, we'll do right leg one time, we'll do left leg the other time. And then we're gonna try some sort of jumping lunges. Okay, y'all ready? We start in 3, 2, 1. So either jumping forwards and backwards, or you're just keeping that single leg, tapping forwards and back. Tappa, 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 tappa. Opposite arm is moving with that leg. You got that core pulled in. And of your standing leg, the weight is in your heel. It's so much easier to draw that knee up instead of this tap. So I'm gonna keep doing that tap because it's doing the hardest thing. 3, 2, 1, take a break. Oh, all right, so you either got jumping lunges one more time, and I'm jealous, or you get to tappa, tappa, tappa. Tappa, tappa, tappa. As fast as you can. Ready? Oh, y'all, it's so sweaty. 3, 2, begin. Tappa, 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 or jump, jump, jump. Keeping that core pulled in tight so that even as my arms and my legs are moving, my body's not wiggle wobbling from side to side. Just keep that weight in your standing leg heel. Don't let it come to the toe. I know if you're like me, it's trying, but take a slightly bigger bend of that knee if you need to, if you're with me tappa, tappa, tapping. 5 seconds left, 4, 3, 2, 1. I still think it's hilarious that like at 8 o'clock this morning, I was like, yeah, we can do jumping lunges in here, it'll be fine. Because those are what's next, jumping lunges. So either keep in with that switch that you were making and taking a little bit of a lunge, or just stepping back into that lunge. Begin. How are you standing up if you're just stepping back, especially if you're not jumping? If you're jumping, it's a lot easier to press through that front heel. But if you're stepping back, there's a lot of temptation to press up through your back foot. Oh, I wish I could do those jumping lunges. So try and get at least one on each side for me. And remember, if you need to, you can always just continue with those split jumps. All right, one more time through. Take a 20-second break. Oh, I missed a move between. I meant to do strength before we challenge our balance here. 3, 2, 1. Maybe we should do these again. Just kidding. It's all right. We got some balance work coming in the next move as well. Hands on your hips can help you with balance. Hands at your chest can help you to keep that chest lifted. If you're jumping, feel free to bring those arms up overhead. Use those arms to help you move through. Press up through that front heel, not just the back ball of the foot. 5 seconds left. Even if you have to move slower to think about lifting through your heel. Oh, he made it. All right, next up, we're gonna do some Romanian deadlifts. I ask if you have two weights to get them. Hold them each in your hands. You're gonna find the hinge that works for your body today, okay? So you're reaching to try to get towards the knees with a nice flat back. reaching towards the knees, not rounding through that upper body by keeping the shoulder blades engaged and the belly pulled in. You can take a slight bend of your knees as you actively send your hips gently behind you. And if you have the flexibility, you're welcome to keep those legs a little bit straighter, make it a little bit more challenging. Round one, we're just gonna do a Romanian deadlift, just down and up. So remember, you can stick with that the whole time. Round two, we're gonna hinge into our Romanian deadlift. We're gonna do a wide row, nice and wide. So not our delightful narrow row like I usually do. Getting a little bit more of that upper back. And then for our final round, we're gonna go for that single leg deadlift and add in an upright row, letting your elbows lean. You ready? Did you enjoy that extra little break? You're welcome. We started in 3, 2, 1, feet are hips width distance apart. Oh, that feels so good. Feels so good. So belly in, hinge forward, hips go behind you. Feel that stretch of your hamstrings, the back of your thighs, and then press into your heels, squeeze, lift yourself up. You can give yourself a little extra squeeze, hip thrust at the top. Awesome. Keep going, keep breathing. Keep that head in line with your spine, so chin is neutral to chest. You're not rolling to the outside or inside of your feet. All right, so this time we're gonna hinge forward. We're gonna get a roll on each side, alternating rows, and then stand ourselves up, begin again. Work at the pace that's right for you with your weights and your body, and go for it. So hinge wide, wide, and lift. This way, if you only have one weight, you can always pass the weight from one hand to another so that you can really challenge yourself with the heaviest weight that you have available to yourself today. Make sure that belly is pulled in every time you hinge forward. And if you're having trouble with this wide row and you need to switch back to a slightly more narrow row, painting the weight up your thigh, that's awesome. Okay, switch into the single leg Romanian deadlift if you can. If you need to, you can have that back toe balancing on the floor or lift it up. Find what works for you. We're gonna lift up into this upright row with elbows leading. Begin. So belly in, hinge forward, press up through your heel, come right into that row. Don't stop in the middle. Press through that heel. Maybe your ankle's a little bit more wiggly wobbly. Maybe you're not able to reach as close down towards the floor as you were with that double leg RDL. 10 seconds left right here on this leg. Remember that back toe can come down towards the floor if you need to, if you need some help with that balance. Oh my gosh, awesome. A little bit of a rest. We'll switch to the other side. And then we only got 2 moves left. 2 moves left. Ooh, we're working right to the end today. 3, 2, 1, other leg, begin. So remember, you can take that slight bend of your knee. Your hips are still driving behind you. You can have that back toe on the floor. Try not to put too much weight on that back toe if it's there. Remember, both sides of the body are not the same. So maybe one side it was really easy to completely balance on one leg, and maybe the other side, you're being smart for your body and you're putting your toe down. 3, 2, 1. Take that 20 second break. We're gonna come right to the top of the mat and do some burpees. So those squat thrusters are coming into play again. For your first one, as you come down into your burpee, stretch up, Come down to the floor. Give yourself 3 shoulder taps on each shoulder. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then you're going to come back up. You ready? So maybe you're adding a jump here at the top. Come on down, step or jump back. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Step or jump forward. Jump at the top if you can add that intensity. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Again. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Try not to let those hips rotate too much this time around, unlike when we were doing those plank twists. You made it. Awesome. One more time around with those shoulder taps. Ooh, shaking it out. 3, 2, 1, begin. If you can add that hop at the top, if not, you press up onto your toes, step or jump back. 6 taps. Step or jump forward. At least try to press up onto those toes. Get those calves engaged a little bit more. Think about really tightening those lower abs to keep from rocking side to side as you tap those shoulders. So really drawing in from the pelvic floor. 1 more time through, everybody. Then we get to lay down on our backs for our last move. We're adding a jumping jack at the back. Sorry, 1 more time. By 1, I mean 2. All right, so reach up. Come on down. 6 taps. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Come on up. 2 jacks. Go down. Less than 10 seconds to go. Awesome. Take your quick little break. We got that 1 more time through. Remember, you can always step your jacks out. In fact, this time, let's do 6 shoulder taps and 2 plank jacks. So step or tap out from those planks. Begin. Stretch up. Come on down, tap it out, jack it out, and then back to the top. Challenge ourselves to 4 full minutes of work. And then I'm gonna ask you to stick around for an extra minute for stretching. Because you're worth it. And because these moves are worth it. Okay. So very last up, we're gonna finish with an ab challenge. We got 4 different moves in our ab challenge. We're gonna start with toe taps. So I want you to reach up and tap your toes. You ready? Begin. Lower back stays glued to the floor. Glued. If you want to add in a little oblique work, you can reach to the outsides of your heels. And if you're having trouble getting these legs straight, you can just work to bring your knees into tabletop and challenge your abs by either having those knees a little further away from the center line of the body, or making it easier on yourself by bringing them in closer. 5 seconds left. Nice. Next up, we're going to go for some leg lifts. So either straight legs, lowering them all the way down. Oh my gosh, you know it sounds fun. I'll tell you when we get started. If you can't do a straight leg lift, you can do a toe tap. If you can't do both toes tapping, you can tap one toe at a time on the floor. Begin. And if that's too hard, you can lift one leg up at a time while really focusing on keeping those abs in. If we're going for leg lifts, let's stop at some angles. So come on down to 11, 10, 9, 8, 7. Well, clearly I can't read a clock because we're really only going to 9 o'clock. So we got 12. Well, this is fun. 11. Adding in a little butterfly kick. 10. 9. Oh, okay. All right, wasn't that interesting? Next, we're going to go for a reverse crunch. So legs are coming back up to the air. You're going to not swing your legs. Arms are down on the floor. As you work to press into your hands, palms, pull your core in, lift yourself up. It's not a swing in your legs to lift your lower back up. Begin. Think about pressing those heels up towards the floor. And if nothing is happening while you're trying to do this, I want you to go back into those toe taps like we had just been doing, or just straight up leg lifts. Work to really control coming down from this reverse crunch. Use your exhale. So squeeze those abs and lift yourself up. Oh, great. All right, next we're going to go for a reverse crunch, and then you're going to add in a leg lift or a toe tap. Reverse crunch, leg lift. Oh, I lied. Toe tap, arms down, reverse crunch. Okay, because we're not swinging those legs. Begin. So reverse crunch, toe tap. Reverse crunch, toe tap. Finish out strong right here, y'all. Just about 30 seconds more of movement for today. If you have something you can hold on to behind you, I don't. But that can also help you with this reverse crunch. 4 seconds left. 3, 2, 1. Awesome. Oh, stay down here on our backs. Go ahead, bring the soles of your feet together. Open your legs nice and wide. Start to get that nice stretch in your hips. Extend your arms out to the side. Slow down your breath. Awesome. Clamshell those legs over to one side. Get a nice stretch in your spine. A little opening of the back. Turn your chin in the opposite direction of your knees. Can you keep both shoulders down on the floor? On your inhale, roll over onto your back. And on your exhale, come to the opposite side. Wow. For that spine twist, if it's accessible, turn your chin towards the opposite shoulder. Get that nice stretch through your neck. Keep the backs of your shoulders down on the mat as much as possible. Great. Roll over to one side, lift yourself up, come into 90-90 with those legs. Nice little deer pose. Work to relax that back glute towards the floor. Turn towards your extended leg. Take a nice twist. Then take that hand to the same side of the leg. Walk it out. Bring that forearm down towards the ground. find a big reach over to the side. Enjoy that stretch through your lower hip and towards your glute. If you want, you can even turn towards the floor, getting that chest towards the floor, stretching more throughout the thoracic spine and core. Awesome, lift yourself up. Let's switch those legs towards the opposite side. Take a moment, first work to just relax your back glute down towards the floor. I know as you twisted, you probably had a lot of weight towards your front leg and it was lifted. So once it's down, turn towards that side of the body. First lift up through the chest, then start to walk that hand away. Maybe it comes down to the floor. Maybe it's just your hand palm on the mat. Find this delightful mermaid reach while still working to bring that back glute down towards the floor. If you want, finding that twist, getting a little bit more through the upper back. There's like totally a hairball attached to my bracelet. Awesome. Bring yourself into tabletop. I'd like to think that's someone else's hairball, but I seem to be the only member of this gym. All right, give yourself a couple cat cows right here. Finding where your body really needs it, so maybe a little bit more of your glutes towards your heels to create more of a stretch through that lower back, or maybe shifting the weight forward, really shimmying one shoulder and then the other. We are out of time today, y'all. So I do encourage you, if you have a couple more moments to yourself or throughout the day, to get up to find a couple additional stretches so that your body continues to feel good. Take your time, press yourself up into down dog, and then walk your hands to your feet and your feet towards your hands. When you get there, bend one knee and then the other. Take a moment, shake your head, yes. Shake your head, no. Bring the weight to your heels and slowly roll yourself up. At the top, take a deep inhale, bring those arms up overhead. Oh, exhale, relax your arms down by your side. Make sure you continue to drink water throughout the day. I'm going to turn the air conditioning back on, save myself. If you have any questions or concerns about anything that I said or we did today, please reach out. Can't wait to see you all again soon. Have a wonderful rest of your day.